Yes. Looks like I killed them all. You cleared out Farrell's garden, you gained 300 experience points. Nice. I should just hit end combat. Alright. Alright. Done. So we're back here at the bed and breakfast. Was it this guy? A wooden pew that has succumbed to the effects of age and abuse. How am I doing? I'm poisoned and radiated? Since when was I radiated? I'm only 3, I'm fine. It was him, he just closed the door again. Farrell. I cleared out all the vermin from your garden. Thank you. You are truly a hero amongst heroes. Not many people would risk their lives for a total stranger. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. What? You get this warm, fuzzy feeling all the way down to your toes. Can I ask you a few more questions? Yes, it does. You mentioned something about a watch earlier. Alright. I miss pots that actually hold things that we can loot from. I am upset about, what's his name? Laddie. Even if you were to sleep by yourself on this thing, you would not be sleeping alone. Come on, guys. Jesus. Alright. We've got some guards of some kind over here. A trader. This used to be a prosperous farming town. These guys don't look like traders. I don't know why I bothered to come here to trade. Oh, these are traders from other towns. Got it. More Brahmin. Don't mind if I do. Oh, there's nothing here. My God, I actually got out. Rose's bed and breakfast. B&B. Oh, got it. BB, like that. I stop by Rose's every chance I get. A pleasantly plump woman. Welcome to Rose's bed and breakfast. Oh my, what a pretty young lady you are. What can Rose do for you today? It'll make my wife jealous. I'm starved. What do you have to eat around here? And so you should be. When was the last time you had a good meal, young lady? Why, you're as thin as a rail. You just look at the menu and tell Rose what you would like to eat. We got Brahmin fries, Wasteland omelet, water, $1,000. Brahmin dogs, Canis burgers, shepherd's stew. No, thank you. I'm not hungry right now. No, you don't have to kick me right out like that. You must hear things working here. Mind if I ask you a few questions? I'm sorry, sweetie. I'm quite busy serving customers. There's only one person in here. Maybe if you ordered something, I'll have time to chat with you between orders. Alright, give me... Why the hell not? A Wasteland omelet. Ah, that's my specialty. I hope you're hungry. I guarantee you've never tasted an omelet like this one anywhere. She leaves and returns with the biggest damn omelet you've ever seen. You feel revitalized after such a big meal. You feel better. I bet Sulik doesn't.
What you be needing?
Nope. He does not feel better. I need a healer for him. I'll have time to chat with you between orders. Brahmin fries. Brahmin fries it is, then. We have a contest on who can eat the most Brahmin fries. So far, the record is 36. If you break the record, you don't have to pay the tab for your meal. You look like you'd be able to beat the record with no problem. Are you interested in trying? I'm so hungry I could probably double that score. Bring it on. Oh, that's just grand. Each order consists of 10 pieces. I'll have to ask you for the money up front. I'll refund it as soon as you break the record. That'll be $20, please. Sure, I'll get it back when I break the record. Rose takes the money and comes back with a heaping platter of Brahmin fries. They're not quite what you expected. They appear to be about the size of golf balls, covered in batter and fried in oil to a deep golden brown. You take a tentative bite of one of the fries. These are delicious. You start into the meal with zeal. I got a meal with zeal. At around the 34th fry, you start to feel the effects of overeating. A crowd is gathered to witness the historic event of the old record being broken. In an attempt to regain your composure, you strike up a conversation with Rose. You pop a fry into your mouth. Don't talk with your mouth full, dear. You swallow. How do you prepare these? If it's not a secret or anything, I know some people back home who would love these. Oh, it's no secret. You just dip them in batter, add some salt, and fry in grease. You pop another one into your mouth. How do you prepare the Brahmin meat? It has such a unique texture. You pop yet another one in your mouth. These are good. That's 37. You just broke the record. And the crowd cheers. You feel like you've gotten your second wind. You are second wind, and pop another fry into your mouth. The crowd yells, 38! Well, what makes ours taste so special is that you have to harvest it while the Brahmin is still alive. What? You just grab the Brahmin by the scrotum and snip four with one cut. You've got to be careful. The Brahmin usually gets riled up at that point. Yeah, no kidding. The 38th Brahmin tidbit must have been going at about the speed of light as is suddenly and forcefully propelled from your mouth. No Anthony Bourdain, are we? We can't count that last one, but you broke the record of 37. Here's your money back. Congratulations. Yeah, we feel sick. I've been poisoned again? You've been poisoned, I think, a second time. Are you kidding? I have ordered plenty of stuff. How about Brahmin dogs? She quickly disappears behind the counter and returns with your order. Can I ask you a few questions? Sure, but make it quick, dear. I don't want to keep the other customers waiting. There's hardly anyone in here. Cornelius's missing watch. The Gek. Ghost farm. Never seen an omelet. What kind of an animal? Yeah, I kind of want to ask all these things. What can you tell me about Cornelius's missing watch? Oh dear, have you been talking to my husband, Cornelius? This whole business with the watch is just terrible. Cornelius has got the whole town believing that his best friend Farrell took his watch. If you've talked to him, I'm sure you've noticed his mind isn't quite functioning properly. I'm pretty sure the poor dear just left the watch somewhere and forgot where. Now, if you don't need anything else, I have other customers to serve. Okay, I'll have a Canis burger. Can I ask you a few questions? Have you ever heard of a geck? Did you say geck? No, I can't say that I have. I have heard of good soup recipe that requires 3 geckos, but no, I have never heard anything about a geck. I'll have shepherd's stew. What do you know about the ghost farm? She shivers involuntarily. Stay away from there. I've heard tales about travelers about rotting bodies tied to stakes and glowing shapes moving through the fields at night. I don't know how much of this is true, but I do know a while back Carl moved out there and hasn't been seen since. I have to order everything every time. Another Canis burger. I've never seen an omelet the size of the one you served me. What kind of animal lays such a large egg? Ah, you've had the desert omelet. You just made it for me. Delicious, wasn't it? Some people say it has healing properties. She looks around nervously. Oh, some customers just came in. I'll be right back. She never answered your question. What's a Canis burger made of? Our burgers are made of nothing but the choicest select grade A dog. The meat is ground up and made into half-pound patties. And to give it that unique smoky flavor, they are slow-grilled over dried Brahmin dung. Oh, God. What? Alright, I want to ask about the omelet. Oh, she still won't answer it. Okay. One moment, I'm still hungry. Alright, never mind. Let's see what's going on back here. Got a locker with nothing in it. Oh God, I almost made it too. Yeah, open that door. Empty locker. Oh, that's a locker from the other room. Another empty locker. An old man. Welcome to Rose's Bed and Breakfast. Oh, my name is Rose. I mean Cornelius. Okay, I thought I was doing Rose. And I run this bed and breakfast. Can I help you? If you run this place, how come it's called Rose's Bed and Breakfast? Rose is my wife. I named this place after her. Do you know I'm married? Can I ask you some more questions? And questions? Was I asking you something? Hi, my name is Cornelius. What do you do here? I run this motel. Yep, this place would fall apart if it weren't for me. Have you been to the outhouse? Cleanest outhouse you've ever been to. That's my doing. What does having a clean outhouse have to do with running this place? Stay away from the chicken coop. I almost lost an arm feeding that thing. Certain words seem to set him off. Rose, room, running. Don't go to the ghost farm unless you're tired of living. Davin is a nice kid. I wonder why he doesn't look anything like his father. Grisham is a nice fellow. He sells us scraps to feed the giant chicken. Farrell's my best friend in the whole world. I hear Grisham is trying to marry off his kids. I wonder if Rose wouldn't mind if I got another wife. I'm afraid she's spoken for now. Have you tried Rose's omelets? They're delicious. Miri is a nice girl. We used to play doctor when she was little. What? I'd say you can go kill him, Miria, but she doesn't have any weapon. Davin is a nice kid. I wonder why he doesn't look anything like his father. I was sitting on a toilet one day and a big dog climbed out of the sewer. Scared me half to death. Who's Rose? Rose is my wife. She runs the kitchen. You won't find a better meal anywhere. Rose, she's so beautiful. I'm going to marry her someday. I thought you just said Rose is your wife. Farrell's my best friend in the whole world. I'm looking for a gold watch. Then why don't you ask that no good Farrell? Maybe he'll sell you the watch he stole from me. Now, if you don't mind, I'm quite busy. I've got to shave the Brahmin. Bye. I'm interested in getting a room. I have a room. I sleep over there. Where do you sleep? I don't think you understand. I would like to rent a room for the night. I was sitting here. You need some serious help, old man. You'll help me? That's great. Go beat up Farrell and get my watch back. He probably hit it good. So tear his house apart and look for it. What are you talking about? A while back, I forgot when, my best friend of 30, or was it 40 years? Doesn't matter. What matters is that he stole my precious gold pocket watch. It has been handed down in my family for four generations. Yep, I distinctly remember setting it down on my desk. Then when I looked on the kitchen table, it was gone. He set it down on the desk and then looked on the kitchen table. Did you try looking for it on your desk? Yes. I've looked in my sock drawer. It's not there either. I'll keep a lookout for your watch while I'm in town. I have a watch. It was a gold watch. I wonder where I put it. Where's this desk? It's not there. So, most probably he did replace. Misplace it. Alright, you're blocking me. You're just walking right up. Okay. I gotta move Vic first. Then him. Then Vic. Then him. Yeah, you are an obstacle. Thank you. At least they don't run in front of me and block me if someone closes the door. There's nothing new here. Still I'm poisoned, but I'm undamaged. Cleanest outhouse in the world. There's an overwhelming smell of methane gas down here. One tiny spark would blow this whole sky high. Yeah, we've got to be on the next save, right? Don't shoot anything. It's full of goo. You study the rocks for a while, but they never move. Yes, Mary is really my wife. An explosive charge could easily... A mole rat. Is the methane there too as well? Alright. Who's got the dynamite? I'll take one dynamite. I think I put it into inventory and go use. Do I get out of here now? We and I think something be wrong with us. You better have be having a look at this limb of ours. NPC crippled.
What you be needing?
Now you tell me he's crippled. Stop drinking my beer. Okay, so I went boom. Oh, we all got hit. Vic and Lenny got hit. You made it out of the hole just in time for the explosion to go off behind you, sending you flying through the air. I guess I got hurt? No? Where's my wife? She's not with us. I mean, if she got killed, it doesn't say that she was killed. Scoping you out of the corner of his eye. Where is she? Is she dead? I don't even know where the hell she is. Now we're gonna be blown to Kingdom Come? We might. I don't even know. I have no idea where she is. I can't hit this thing. Okay. He shot something. I mean, he shot a gun and nothing happened. The body. Oh, at the groin. I missed. See, that's why I don't do this very often. Okay, we're reload. Don't shoot me in the back. It's almost dead. Down to John. Bones. Oh no, fruit. Cornelius's gold watch. Look at that. A shovel. Who the hell is burying it down here? I mean, I'd be sad if my wife died, but then again, I didn't know her very well. I wouldn't be surprised if she died sooner or later. She only has 36 hit points. You think she was killed in that explosion, but I see no mention of it, and I don't see her body down here. Maybe she wandered off somewhere? Oh boy, this really hurts. Yeah, I get the idea with Sulik. Not sure who can heal him. Yeah, I don't know where she is. Taking damage from poison. Oh, no longer poison, at least. Can you get there? What do you say? I can't what? I can't feel this limb anymore? He's damaged too? We need to get healed, gotta find out where. This town is dying. We've been in here, right? Oh, she's right here. No, that's not her. People shouldn't mess with the supernatural. Another shovel. Well, the dogs are attacking each other. The dogs seem trained to protect what's inside the shed. Alright. am I? Oh. Oh, they opened the door. Oh, it's boarded up. Look at that. Here they come.